So we had three objectives on our school action plan this year. The first was that during the school year, teachers would collaborate in teams of 2 to 5 twice a month to plan instruction and review data. We talked a lot about differentiation throughout the year and how we would meet students where they were and either go up and challenge them or bring the content down a little bit to really support children where they were and help them build those skills to meet their peers. In addition, we had a monthly planning meeting and the team focused on what students know, what they want them to learn, and what they were going to do if students didn't learn what was being taught. We were very fortunate this year to be able to collaborate with Dr. Jen Santiago, who's the LEAP coordinator, and she helped us to realize that what teachers are doing in their classrooms by providing a language-rich environment and making sure that there's lots of opportunity to use and practice English language really is best practices for young students. We were able to collaborate really nicely with Julie Macrina, who's the Multi-Tiered Systems of Support, or MTSS, coordinator for the school division. And she helped us, along with Dr. Jason Cheka, who's the school psychologist, to develop a plan for MTSS. So for Tier 1, when we just have a concern about a student, we had a kid talk and a discussion about where they were and what those concerns were. And we were able to work in our collaborative teams and really discuss where students were and what we could do to help them. We also developed a process if we need to go to Tier 2 or Tier 3, which is more intensive interventions. And we developed that process and how we would use it moving forward. This past year, we've really enjoyed collaborating with teachers from around the division. So Jamie Sample is our music teacher this year, and she's also the high school choir director. And she was able to bring over some of her students to sing with our little guys in December, which everyone enjoyed all around. We've also had Joe Musket come over and do PE, so that has given us more of a connection to Mount Daniel. So really building those strong foundations to be a pre-K-12 school division has been really nice. As we move forward, I'm really sad to leave JTP and FCCPS, but I know we've got lots of systems in place for a fabulous school year next year, and I look forward to hearing about how things go.
As I begin to wrap up my first year as a principal in Falls Church, I can say that it's been a very exciting year. We've already undergone many changes. Our facility is beautiful, and we've been able to maximize the space to provide world-class educational opportunities for our students. And looking forward, we are so excited to welcome the second grade team and to be able to keep our current first graders as the first cohort of second grade students at Mount Daniel. One of our objectives this year was to provide equitable core instruction, resources, and training for both students and staff. Teachers have designated collaboration time to learn with each other to ensure core instruction is happening at a very high level. Additionally, professional development opportunities are available to all teachers and staff. We're looking to have 2 collaborative team meetings per week where teachers can learn together, analyze student data, and focus on student achievement. PYP is embedded in our daily instruction. For example, our kindergarten team has been learning about Mexico and the geography of Mexico. In science, our children are learning about volcanoes. So what the kindergarten team has done is talked about the geography of Mexico and where volcanoes might be located in Mexico. Another objective for the year was to establish at least 2 co-teaching models for special education and a more deliberate push-in model for our LEAP students by the end of 2020. Special education teachers and general education teachers have had professional development focused on co-teaching. We have 1 co-teaching model in kindergarten and 1 co-teaching model in first grade. Additionally, the teachers work together to plan instruction that's designed to meet the needs of all the students that they serve, whether it's in a general education setting or in a special education setting. Our LEAP teachers have been visiting schools in surrounding jurisdictions, learning various ways to successfully implement a push-in model in which co-teaching will support the needs of our English language learners. So our third objective was to design structures and opportunities to collaborate within grade level teams and departments, as well as school-wide or cross curriculums. And we want those structures to be in place by the 2019 school year. As we prepare for the 2019 school year, we're collectively writing a school vision and mission that reflects our core values and beliefs around instruction and student achievement. We are planning our master schedule to reflect these values so that we can maximize our instructional time to meet the needs of our students. These changes are exciting for the entire division. We're hopeful to continue our vertical articulation with Thomas Jefferson and to align some of our structures and practices to continue to meet the needs of our students as we look at a K-5 continuum.
We thought, I think in broad terms, about who are the kids that could most benefit from our extra help, and then we also thought systematically about what are the programs that can umbrella over all kids and what are those programs that we could choose to focus on. And so one of the goals asked us to be at or above the state average in math for our ESOL students. Jennifer Fessenden has taken on even more of a leadership role in helping us to evolve the use of number talks. So many of our math lessons begin with number talks. That's been very helpful for a lot of our kids to just develop conceptual understandings. We have also introduced a before school math club here, and we don't necessarily think of that as a band-aid, but we do think of it as something that's been helpful for the roughly 40 to 50 kids that are coming. We have had a training session on the use of anchor charts. So the idea is, particularly for our LEAP kids, to make math classrooms even more visually accessible so that kids are not only hearing this lesson, but they're seeing in a visual sense reminders about here's what this concept means, here's the definition of this mathematical term. We have, with the leadership of Jennifer Santiago, begun a LEAP cohort here. So we have monthly meetings of our teachers that will get together and talk about some facet of LEAP and ESOL instruction. We, like all Falls Church schools, are really committed to the IB program. It's something we care about. We desperately want to be outstanding at it. And one of the revelations for us at the beginning of this year is that when we did a survey of our staff to gauge their comfort level, there was a pretty wide swath of staff members that indicated that they didn't have full comfort with implementing the elements of the PYP in their classrooms on a daily basis. One of the things that we did was that Carrie Checa, our K-5 PYP coordinator, along with our fifth grade team, did a professional development session on provocations. Provocation essentially is a way to begin a lesson in a creative, engaging way that gets kids wondering, where's this lesson going? Why are we doing this? Previously, we had a PYP meeting for each grade level once a month. We've doubled that. We're now meeting twice a month. And during those meetings, we've got teams that are talking about planners, they're talking about summative evaluations, all the components of the IB experience. This summer, we have around 13 staff members that are going to an international baccalaureate official training, and we're looking to send those folks to different workshops and things like that. We've had third and fifth grade really working hard on performance-based assessments, and one of the neat things about those grade levels is that they have begun to do what we call a crosswalk. In other words, we're looking at individual IB themes, like how we organize ourselves, where are we in time and place. And we're looking not only at the central idea and what themes are we covering, but then we're also marrying that with Virginia State standards to figure out what standards are we teaching in each one of these units. So it's been helpful to be able to marry the IB program with SOLs, but it's also been helpful to make sure that we, in fact, are teaching all the standards that we need to. We view this as a transition this year, a transition into a season of mighty change. We are seeing an entire grade level go to a different school. We're having staff that's being transferred to meet needs across the district. So it's going to be a new school next year. So I think that we envision, while we continue to work on school planning documents and school planning goals, I think that we envision a chance to really hit a reset on what is already a very good program here, and to think about how can the new Thomas Jefferson, with three grade levels instead of four, how can we raise our level of excellence even higher?